Welcome
to the Color and Life Podcast,
episode 18, part 1.
Or welcome back. Whichever part works for you.
Whichever
you
matches
your... You didn't say your line. Jeez, you're just all over the place today.
I really am. Okay. It's been a... We did our survey. My brain is working on all these projects now. Anyway. Okay.
No, you can't knit on them all at once. You haven't developed super mind powers yet.
All right.
That comes next year.
Are we getting to start over?
No.
All right. We'll just keep going.
That was too hilarious to miss.
All right. So, I am Jennifer. This is Jen Michael. I can be found as Genuine Knits on Instagram and Facebook and other social media type places. And Junip on Ravelry.
And I'm Sandboxer7 on Ravelry and nowhere else. It's important.
Why?
Because there might be a Sandboxer7 on Instagram, and then they would follow him and get, like, pictures of cars and stuff.
Or something.
Okay. Yeah, exactly.
All right. So that almost makes sense.
Yeah, it almost does. But the real reason is elsewhere.
Okay. So, we are switching things up just a little bit. We are going to be doing our show and tell.
So instead of your regularly scheduled program, that has been canceled, and we are going to
It hasn't been canceled. It's just been reordered.
Postponed. We are going to mix it up in 2017. We're going to start doing the show and tell first.
The color part.
The color part, yes. So it's going to be in order of our name. We're going to do the color first and then the life.
So it's going to be show and tell and then the conversation. So color and then life.
Mm-hmm. And so this is the color segment where we talk about all of the beautiful colors.
And we do a survey of Area 51.
In this particular one.
Yes.
In particular.
Because if you remember from the last one, for those of you who watched... I was referred to as Area 51. So.
It is inaccurate.
With all the UFOs, I suppose. Okay.
I suppose you're not very secretive about them, though.
Yeah, I'm not very secretive.
Hence the whole podcast thing.
Yeah. Alrighty, and then the...
It doesn't quite work that way, but...
So what are we doing? Oh...
So we have
had
our...
some snacks. We had some cheese and crackers and Belvedas and water.
Yep. They're club crackers. The best of crackers.
And...
No one likes
this. This episode, we've got our cow that we're announcing.
Yes, we're announcing the cow.
The Double Dog Dare cow.
The Color and Life Double Dog Dare cow.
Color and Life Double Dog Dare cow. Thank you. I keep thinking of the hashtag. Hashtag Double Dog Dare cow.
Yes.
And then we have show and tell, which is the survey of Area 51.
Quite more extensive and faster than you're used to.
Anyway.
We're still winded.
Yeah. And then we have our featured, our maker of the month.
Yes, which is WickedEweFiberArts.
WickedEweFiberArts. Yay, Mandy.
So.
And is that it? That's it.
Yep.
On with the show. There's a lot, so let's get on with it.
We've teased. We've tantalized. I hope you're ready, because now it's time for the Color and Life Double Dog Dare Knit Along.
Welcome
to the Color and Life Podcast.
And the Dog Dare Podcast.
We are doing a joint cow, and this is the announcement for it. Michael.
So I came up with this idea when we were watching one of Dog Dare's podcasts, and I was thinking Dog Dare. Oh, what if we did like a double Dog Dare, and then it could be a cow, and it could be a joint thing, and I was just like, oh, we can do this cow! And so,
And then I talked to you, and?
And I thought it was a fantastic idea. Jumped right on board.
Okay, so we're calling it the Color and Life Double Dog Dare Cow. because we are doubling up to do a Cal, and we're going to give each other a double dog dare.
Yes.
For something that stretches ourselves outside of each of our comfort zones.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit. And we thought it was good to start at the new year because, you know, that's the time when you're
making
resolutions and doing things.
So,
David, are you ready?
I think I am ready, yes.
Okay.
You have said on your podcast that you want to learn how to knit socks and even have lessons planned out.
That is correct, yes.
Okay, so David,
we double dog dare you to become a sock knitter.
Okay, that's quite a challenge.
So that means you have to knit two pair of socks.
Four socks total.
Okay.
One pair is going to be a vanilla pair, and then the other pair is patterned.
You can do it plain if you want. You can do both of them patterned if you want, but one can be a plain, but then you got to stretch a little bit further and do a patterned one, too.
Okay. That's a stretch for me just doing a vanilla, but I am willing to take the double dog dare and do one adult-sized vanilla and one adult-sized pattern sock during this Cal. I will take it on. Pair of socks. Yes, two pairs. Four individual socks.
Yes. So... And, good pointing out that they're adult size. You can make them shorter. They can be ankle size.
Yeah.
You know, you don't have to make them, like, knee high or anything, but...
Okay.
That's just nutty.
So you can make them the length that's comfortable for you to wear, because that's the point for you to wear them. But they can't be, like, you can't get away with, like, oh, I knit two baby socks.
Darn it.
That's kind of cheating.
All right. Two pairs of adult socks. I'm game. I'm ready.
Okay, so... David, it's time for us to talk to John Michael.
Should I be scared?
John Michael.
Maybe. You don't like following patterns. And you've never done lace, right?
No, I haven't.
So, John Michael, David and I, double dog dare you. To do what?
To follow a pattern. Buy the pattern and the whole pattern and nothing but the pattern in a lace pattern.
Yep. Ah. So help him yarn. He has to follow the pattern, the whole pattern, and nothing but the pattern, so help him yarn.
Exactly.
I accept your challenge.
And it has to be a proper lace pattern.
Oh, yeah, not just yarn overs.
You can't just, like, increase on edges or something with yarn overs. That's not.
Yeah, okay.
That's cheating. So just like David can't do baby socks, you have to do a proper lace pattern.
Okay. I think I can do that.
Okay. So, are you excited about this?
I am. I am quite excited for
this
adventure into lace.
I'm surprised that you're excited about following the pattern, the whole pattern, and nothing but the patterns will help you yarn.
I'm going to kind of have to for the lace. That's
true. We made that a little easier on him.
If it's lace... Gonna have to.
Okay.
So, David and I now need to double dog dare you. And before we say our dare, let me just say, her comfort zone is probably as big as ours put together. So we had to push a little bit farther to get her outside of her comfort zone. So,
absolutely.
With that, David and I double dog dare you... To downsize Area 51.
Area 51? Oh, yeah. Area 51. All my UFOs.
Yes. You have to finish 31 of them.
Oh, yeah, because we did a count the other day.
Yes. So she has 43 UFOs. Not all of them are in Ravelry. And because she has so darn many. And so we did a count... And she has to get her final number down below 10. And two of them don't count because one of them is her scrappy blanket, which is meant to go over a long time.
Yeah.
And the other one is her octagonal blanket. And that one's really big. And she hasn't quite...
It's an Afghan.
...put it together yet, so.
And it's a design, too. So, yeah, it was interesting as I was cleaning up my office, they just kept coming. So it's time to clean up Area 51, I think. And now, do I have to finish them all?
No, you don't. She doesn't have to finish, necessarily. She can, if she decides, this really isn't going to be a project. I'm never going to finish this. I'm not going to enjoy it. She can frog it, and nothing more will be said about that.
Okay. Are you okay with that, David?
I think it's a great thing. I think it's a huge a task to take on, so more power to you, but I think it's great.
Okay. So I have to finish or frog all but 12, because I get to keep the thing. But all but 10, without those two exceptions, of my current UFOs.
But wait, there's more.
What?
You have to also finish... See, when we were going through your UFOs, we found several patterns that you were designing.
Oh, yeah.
So you also have to finish those patterns. And you have to publish them. And that is actually our fourth option for you at home to follow along with us.
We haven't described the other three.
And this is where the along part comes in.
Oh, okay. So now we're going to tell the along part.
So the first one is me. If you want to knit my pattern, you just knit my pattern and you knit along. And I'll be talking about it over here on the Color and Life podcast. And just follow along in the UFO thread and enjoy yourself. David, I'll turn it over to you to how they can follow along with you.
Yep. If you want to follow along with me for the Dog Dare podcast, you will be casting on. To qualify, you have to cast on two pairs of adult-sized socks in 2017. Follow along with me, two adult-sized pair. They can both be pattern. If you're new to it, you can do one vanilla, one pattern. That'll sync up with what my double dog dare is.
Now, David, these have to be new sock knitters, right?
Yeah, they can't be like Mina Phillips over there with all of her socks.
Yeah, Mina's disqualified.
And what's great about that is there have been a lot of people who have reached out to me to say that, hey, they've never knitted socks or they've tried before and they've gotten discouraged. So this is a great way for us all to go along.
Yes, I think those people qualify perfectly for your part of the knit along.
Perfect. Great.
So they can play along with you. And so how do they play along with me? How do viewers play along with me? Well, in order to qualify for the first part of my dare, because you guys quadruple dog dared me. You double dog dared me. So that's a quadruple dog dare. So because I've been quadrupled, well, we'll start with the first part. So for the first part, you have to be a little nuts like me and have to have 15, more than 15 UFOs.
Yes. 15 or more. If you have 15 or
those are unfinished
or greater,
objects.
Yes, unfinished objects or works in progress or things of that nature.
Things in that category. So if you have more than 15 UFOs, you have to reduce that count by 10.
Yes.
Now these are for both of us. These are UFOs that are existing right now.
Yes.
I get to cast on more things.
Oh, yeah, we forgot to mention that. She is allowed to cast on more things because she's working on this sock knit-along.
And some other things.
Yeah, and some other things. So she does get to cast on more.
So it's not my
total... That was her caveat.
It's not my total of UFOs. It's just the total of the current number at this time.
Yeah, she's finishing so 31 of them now.
I'll put a list in the Ravelry thread that I'll set up. That lists all of the UFOs that are done, and I'll edit that post to show which ones are getting finished. Does that work?
Yep.
Yep.
Okay.
Now, for the second part of her dare, she has to finish her patterns. And the way you play along with that is if you knit or are a test knitter for any of her designs, then you can enter in that category under the knit along. And the other part of this is that you don't have to pick one of these. So if you want to do mine and dog dares, then please do. You can do all four if you want, if you're really nuts.
If you're a crazy person that has lots of UFOs, but you've never knit socks and you want to knit a lace pattern, and you want to try one of mine? Actually, one of
really, I really encourage you to do that if you are that brave.
One of my patterns you can actually double dip with, and you could do one of my patterns because it's a lace pattern, and you could do...
No, they have to knit my pattern.
Oh, they have to knit... That's right, they have to knit your pattern. Okay. I for a second I was thinking, oh, say, just kidding.
Yeah.
So you'd have to do two things to enter mine and John Michael's.
Yep.
So you have to do all the things if you want to enter all the Cals.
Yep.
But do they get, this is a good question, do they get more than one entry in the fourth category if they knit more than one pattern of mine?
I would say so.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think so too.
So, if you knit all my patterns, then you get all the entries.
Yep.
So, that's a way you can get more entries, I guess.
Yep.
Okay. And, let's see. We're going to... This is... How long is it going to be going on? We haven't told them yet.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Let David do that. David, how long is this going to be going on?
Yes. This Cal is going to go all the way till January 21st. Which is the start of solstice. June 20th, 2017. This will go till June 20th, 2017.
Summer solstice.
Yes, summer solstice. Perfect. Perfect okay. timing. So that gives everybody plenty of time to tackle one or all of our double dog dares and double dog dares.
Yes. And we will be doing, just to get you going sooner too, because, you know, it's kind of a big deal. We will have drawings the end of March from the threads.
Yes.
Now, all the threads will be hosted on the Color and Life podcast.
Just so they're all in one place.
In the Ravelry group. You do have to be a member of both groups. Both Dog Dare's Ravelry group and our Ravelry group. And, what's the other thing? Instagram. We're going to be doing some other random Instagram prize kinds of things. So that means you have to know the hashtag for this Cal, which is...
Hashtag Double Dog Dare Cal. That's hashtag Double Dog Dare Cal.
And I'll put
it... Make sure you tag your photos with those. Somewhere.
All right. And I think that's it. I am Genuine Knits on Instagram. And you are David Dogdare.
At Dogdare. Correct. Yep. Correct.
Okay.
And I'll make sure on my Ravelry page to post a link to direct people to go to my Ravelry page. We'll direct them directly to your Color and Life podcast Ravelry page so they can get all the information and entries there.
Right, where all the threads are and so they can enter. But you'll have all the rules posted in a thread on yours.
Mm-hmm. And the other thing is, yeah, we'll have the rules posted all the places on all of the individual threads on the Color and Life podcast and on David's podcast Ravelry page. So,
okay. I'm really excited about this.
I am too. I think this is going to be a great way to spend the first half of our year.
It'll be a great way for everybody to join and play along.
Yeah, and I'm really excited for Area 51 to be addressed.
Yes.
Sure.
We're going to do a survey.
It was funny because we found one of her patterns when we were looking that was almost as old as her knitting career.
That's true. That's true. I have a UFO.
It was kind of worrying, actually.
I have a UFO that's been floating around that was cast on before I had finished my first two cast-ons after kind of getting back into knitting again.
Wow, that's amazing.
It was...
That's awesome.
It was like, oh, yeah, I guess I should make a decision about this one.
I've been running from that one for long enough.
And I think it's great for everybody to play along because, you know, we've all heard a lot of people who have a little bit of stress around their whips and their mountains of whips. And so this gives a chance for everybody to go through all their stuff and decide if they're going to finish it or make that decision if they decide not to finish one of them and unravel it. So it gets it off their list in their mind.
And they don't have to complete 31 like me. They just need to do 10.
Yeah. 10 of their 15 or more. So even if they have 40, that's 15 or more and you only have to do 10 of them. So. If you want to do more, though, please don't let us stop you. We want you to complete your whips.
Or make a decision about them one way or another.
Yeah.
Exactly. This is exciting. This is going to be great. Looking forward to it.
This is great. Okay, well, thanks, David, and I think we better get ready to get this posted and get it going so everybody can start playing.
Yep.
Thanks, everybody. Good luck.
Thanks. Oh, we'll have more of these throughout the cow. We'll get together and do more of these.
Yep.
Absolutely.
All righty.
Perfect.
Thanks.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
See ya.
That was excellent.
I'm glad. I gave it my all.
Okay. So, that will have been... You will have just seen our wonderful...
We need to include the bit of you chuckling when I... You were just like...
What?
It was like you couldn't contain yourself.
We'll see. Okay. And now we are finished with announcing our make-along, and it's time for what's up next?
Show-offs. Because...
Show-offs. We have to survey Area 51.
Yes.
It's time for our survey, which means... I don't think we can nip and survey Area 51 at the same time. We're going to start with the survey.
I'll use my mind powers.
We're going to start with our survey. What we're going to do is we're going to go through every single... The show and tell this time is going to be the survey of Area 51. But what's going to happen is we're just going to show briefly all of my... UFOs that have to be decided about, finished or frogged one way or another, or left as UFOs, because I get 10.
You get 10
that I get to leave as UFOs.
Only 10.
You guys have to finish 10, but I only get 10.
So. Yep.
It doesn't quite seem fair, but all right, so we have to stop our knitting.
Pick off the top of the pile over here.
All right, this is the Echo Flowers shawl. I don't know when the last time, that's not it. That's another pattern.
That's a different pattern. Okay. Mm-hmm. We're going to have
to sort through a stack of patterns. So just put those
patterns aside. Oh, okay.
Set the patterns aside and hold it up. This is being made with...
Ooh.
Yeah.
See, this is pretty.
It is really pretty.
This is one you need to finish.
Yeah, I think this one's going to get finished.
I want to see this one all blocked. Oh, and I was looking at the wrong side, too. Holy...
No, that's the right side.
No, I was looking at this side and I was like, ooh, that's pretty.
Oh, yeah. So, and it's got beads, too.
Oh, see, now that's pretty.
So it's got nups. Well, I don't think they're nups
and
exactly.
And it's all purple
it
and...
It's actually fantastic. Being knit with two different... Here, pick up the two silks.
Oh.
This is silk. This is,
Oh, no wonder. I mean...
Trainway silks. Like... Just hold it up. Just hold forward.
There we go.
So it's these two beautiful different colors of silk that I'm holding together.
And they're coming through really well.
Yeah. That I'm holding together to make kind of this different color. And I don't know if you can see the beads very well, but they do show up very nicely in real life. And it really needs to be blocked so you can see it. Here, I'll help stretch it out so you can see.
Oh, that's just fantastic.
What that looks like. I'll stretch it out.
And you can zoom in.
All right. Something. So that's one. We're going to kind of go through this at a brisk pace. I may give...
That was already more than your 30 seconds. Come out of your next one.
Yeah. We'll see. Okay, so that's...
Next one.
One of them. This is one that is... Got some of the yarn ready. This is the Aluna shawl.
Very nice. Paid for pattern?
Yeah, paid for pattern. The Aluna...
It looks something like this, or it does when it's done.
And it's going to be made with this yarn from Up in Yarn, not from, yeah, that's Up in Yarns, along with two from Colorful Eclectic. And it's okay that you're getting brief little teases of this right now because
they'll be back.
They'll be back as I finish them and as I do stuff. We've got to check off.
Oh, okay.
So that was the Aluna. We've got to check these off because there's a whole bunch of them. And the Echo Flower shawl. That's
that?
On this.
Which one? Where?
It's probably back. Echo Flower Shawl.
Perfect. Okay.
Okay. This is the watchlet. And you might think this is done. This is done with my hand spun. And it's not. Because you need to hold that up so they can see that right there. See that? That is all that I bound that off. No. The bind off.
Oh, right here?
The little tail.
Oh.
Yeah, that. Don't pull on it too hard. Put it down. It's not even in camera.
Oh, oops.
Okay, that little fluffy fibery thing, there's no way that that bind off is going to stay. So what I have to do is spin a little bit more yarn. I have to take this bind off out because I bound off really tight to try to preserve, and I don't like that. And I have to bind off, I have to either back up or something and spin some more yarn and then graft it into this. And so I can bind off because there's no way that's going to hold. That's going to unravel.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so this is not finished. It may appear to be finished, but it's not. And this is the watchlet. So that one's not a frog. This one may be a frog. This is that one with the beads that I was... Okay, so this is being made with alpaca.
It's very pretty.
Yeah, it is really pretty. But I'm not... It's hard to see. There we go.
Oh, man.
Because it starts out at the top. This is the top here. And then it's going down. Here, turn it this way so people can orient their brains the right way. And I was modifying a little bit, and there's beads all in here. This is the wrong side. This is the right side. Here.
Hang on. Oh, did we show the right side?
Yeah, we showed the wrong side.
Oh, okay.
Hold it up so they can see the beads.
There we go.
Can they see the beads now? Nope, you need to hold it up so they can...
I was holding it up.
Anyway, so there's these eyelet rows. I don't know if... I don't know.
Well, if you do decide to prog it, can I have the yarn?
Okay, we'll reserve that question for another time. So this is the Simplicity shawl. That's in here. That's on this page.
Here you go.
So the Simplicity shawl is another one.
Maybe I'll make that.
This is the Eiffel Gold. It's got this much. I know, it's really tiny. But this is Black Raspberry by Colorful Eclectic. And then this is Give Me Sorbet, and this is going to be the light color.
See, you work yourself into these jams by knitting just that much on one of your UFOs and then casting on a new one.
Well, happens. Here's a picture.
Just saying.
This is the Eiffel Gold. So it's going to look like that with the black cherry.
Absolutely fabulous.
Or black raspberry as the dark, and then the Give Me Sorbet as the light.
And these pictures aren't coming through at their best, and we don't exactly...
We're kind of going fast.
Yeah. So, look them up. Because
there's a lot.
Look them up.
All of these will be... Wait. Some of these are on my Ravelry page, but all of these will be on my Ravelry page. Probably not exactly by the time...
Here we go, just like this.
Probably not by the time the podcast airs exactly, but hopefully relatively shortly thereafter. 30 of them are already up on Ravelry. Okay, so these are the... There's two different projects here.
Oh.
It's a Both of these are Colorful Eclectic yarn. This is Nymphadora's Secret Socks, and these are also... I'm showing them briefly. Briefly? Yeah, done.
Okay. This is the color of the...
And these are my... These are my patterns.
Oh, okay.
These are going to be my patterns. And this is...
Slytherin. Called it.
So, Slytherin socks. Yep.
I was guessing.
Okay. So, those two. Those are on Ravelry.
Okay.
So they need to be checked off on the thing. It's Nymphadora's Secret Socks and Slytherin socks.
Okay.
Cool. All right, next. This is... Oh, my pond... My,
Scribblecini.
Scribblecini. I like it, but I don't know. We'll see. So, Scribblecini. And next. Scribblecini is...
Silken Scribbles.
Silken Scribbles. Okay.
That's it.
All right. This one, I'm not going to show. I'll show you the yarn, but I won't show... what it is because this is one of my own designs. So this is one that has to be done. I'm calling it market bag. This is being done with Barocco Remix.
Okay. She pointed to something.
I have some more up there.
With all of this yarn around, I can't tell what it was.
It's that box. It says Remix in it.
Oh.
It has my Remix in it. Okay.
This one, shown on the podcast before.
Yes. These are my WickedEwe.
Fruit stripe gum.
Fruit stripe. Fruit stripe colorway. WickedEwe. And
actually named that now.
Yeah. I think she did actually name it. So, this is fruit stripe. Just a second. Yes, be careful. So, these are going to be finished soon.
Yeah, they'll be like the first object.
Some things in this pile, because, you know, I kind of had a little bit of a heads up about this, have kind of been saved for being cast off. And that's one that has been. So that should be cast off soon. Okay, wait, just a second. So those are the WickedEwe. So mark those off while I show this next thing. So these are the pencil socks.
Oh, I'll mark those off too.
And these actually had a little bit of progress. So here are my pencil socks. Pencil socks. Okay.
I knew that. I was just testing.
And this next one is complicated. Because it's got, again, it's two
yarn.
Zephyr yarns being held together.
This is the yarn.
And this one's really, I'm going to lose some stitches here. All right, and this is a box shawl that is.
Ooh, does it end up like a box?
Being knit in the round. It's a square shawl. It looks
like
it ends
up like a box.
This is the right side of it.
Ooh, right side.
Wait, no, don't help right now. Don't help.
Don't help.
Yeah, so this is kind of from the edge to the middle. The middle is right there. Right where my finger pokey is. That's how wide, and of course it needs to be blocked out.
Is it almost
done? But I'm using two colors of Zephyr. This is probably about 3/4 done.
Okay.
So.
Needs some work.
It needs some work, and then it's going to get one beads,
of those,
too.
One of those shawls that gets.
But see, it looks
longer.
Like a big bag right now, because it's.
It could be a big bag
because
right
I'm
now.
Knitting it in the round. Here's the needle. And you see all the stitch markers marking my.
Repeats,
yeah. This is Mimosa. My Mimosa. And this
the
one.
End of the list.
Oh. These are my Bedelia socks. I'm impressed.
What?
Because we've done way more than 13. We're staying pretty good. These are my Bedelia socks. And these need to be finished. It's this wonderful Socrates.
Oh, they are.
Yarn, I know.
They're fantastic. Like,
I know, I really need
to
finish them.
On multiple levels.
Mm-hmm.
You need to finish them and give them to me.
Wrong answer. They wouldn't fit you.
Oh, that's true.
And I'm not going to knit them to fit you.
I have quite the flippers.
Okay, so I've started the gussets. It's from a pattern from sock knitting. This is Lady Russell.
I'm working on doing it justice.
Yeah, and it's a shawl. It's a 3-panel shawl that increases, and then it's got things on it. It's hard to tell. This is a lace one.
It's difficult to block out.
Yeah.
With my hands. Monster as they are.
So, that's the Lady Russell, and that one's in here. Lady Russell.
Here you go.
These are my crocus socks.
Wait, did we get the last one? That one. Those socks. Did we get them?
Yeah. Oh, checked off? No. They are on the other page. Those.
Okay.
Okay. And these are my crocus socks. Hold those up. These I have been working on for a really, really,
really,
really,
really
long time.
Really long time.
They're wonderful.
They're just complicated.
They're beautiful.
As you can tell.
They're not even really that complicated. They just.
No,
I don't know why they.
Nope, they are definitely complicated.
I don't know why they don't get all that much love, but.
Because you have lost ambition for that pattern, And you keep gaining ambition for other things, so there's room for ambition to grow.
Possibly.
That's why I'm going to take all of your whips away and leave you with that one.
No, you're not. Nice try.
That one and the other wonderful socks that you haven't been knitting on forever.
Aren't those great socks? But I need vanilla socks. That's the thing, is I end up with these potato chippy ones, and the ones that need attention don't get it. Oh, that's a finished project. Those are just, that's just stuff that needs to be put away.
I'm sorry.
This was what my cherry blossom socks were in.
Isn't it like never okay to use potato chip and knitting in the same sentence together?
No. This is Saturn's rings, and it's done
with fantastic.
Yeah, by Very Busy Monkey.
There's a little. It looks like there's less green than there is. Yeah, there's a little bit more green
than there is, and this is a
mystery yarn.
No, it's why can't I remember the name of this company right now?
It's a
Malabrigo.
Oh, okay.
It's a Malabrigo sock yarn.
Really? You forgot that name?
I know, I was blanking on it. Okay.
You keep them in business.
I know. Okay, this is my foolproof.
Single-handedly.
And this might be finished, not single-handedly. Might be finished.
Oh, hey,
by the end of today.
Is it already connected together?
Really, yeah.
Oh, man.
See?
Oh, it's neat.
Okay, so show it. So show it this way.
Yeah, okay.
So this is the foolproof. This is going to be wonderful, Cal.
It is going to be wonderful.
I love it. Okay.
Oh, and then you get to do the thing that I was doing with mine.
Look, it's going to look so cool with this top.
You can do that thing that I was doing with mine where you twist it in half and then you use one bit as a cowl and one bit as a headband.
I'm going to...
It covers your ears and it's wonderful.
Possibly you need to stop talking over the top of me or people can't hear me.
Oh.
All right. So this is...
I didn't want them to hear you. I wanted them to hear me.
This is where I was and I went this way. And this is where I was... And I went to here. And then to this stripe right here, to this thicker one. And then I did this middle V section too. So this is almost finished. I stopped right before I was done.
Doesn't count.
Yes, it does.
That totally does.
Yes, it totally counts. With how many things I have, this totally counts.
Yeah.
So I need to finish this.
Except it wouldn't because you're getting below 10.
Because I still...
So you actually didn't have to stop because you didn't have a quota. So because it wasn't a quota, it doesn't actually matter.
Stop
you just
it.
Have to go below 10.
So I just need
to...
And I need to weave in ends.
You could have casted all of these off.
Because I need to weave in the ends and stuff. But this will make me feel really like, yes, I finished all this stuff. And then I'll have finished objects to show. Okay.
Okay, but you can't finish them all at once because then you won't have anything to motivate you... To re-spur you on halfway through the
this is
knit-along.
Mostly warmless. It's a cowl and a mitts combination by Martina Bem. And that is in this yarn here. And it's got little purples in it. And this is a juniper... No, this isn't juniper moon. This is Finley. DK. This is Finley DK. Okay. Which is a juniper moon.
Something extremely lacy over here.
Okay. These are... This is cashmere. These are... And you don't get to touch these. I'll put my hand in. These are... I called them... Lacy bedroom socks. Have you been checking stuff off? And these are just to... Oh, these are just wonderful. They're these light. I would never wear them. So.
Elegant bedroom socks.
Elegant bedroom socks. That's what I called them. So. And this is my own pattern too.
Star next to my design.
See, where's elegant bedroom socks? Did you get those?
Yeah, I got them.
Okay. All right. Next.
Where's the foolproof?
It is right here. This is the swallowtail. This one you do need to hold up. This is the swallowtail shawl. And this is this is camel. And this is also from Trainway Silks. And this, as much as I love it, is possibly a frog.
That would just take candidate. So long.
Just so, it's not so
that
long.
It, no, it's not that it actually takes long. It just... I'm not... Anyway, we'll see. We'll see what the decision is. This is... You need to mark that one off. I think it's on the other page.
What is it called?
Swallowtail. This has just the beginning of a cast on.
Ha!
Still haven't counts. Even joined. And this is the Jango Mitts.
Ah, Jango Mitts. Oh, man.
Yeah. And this is being knit. These are the Jango Mitts.
Here, let me see that. I gotta get me some of those.
And it's being knit with the Amano yarns. So. Yummy.
Yeah, here, I need a copy of this pattern. That's gonna be one of my new... You're infecting me! Go away!
Okay.
Get away from careful. Me. You're infectious.
One of those has a yarn thing that's gonna possibly fall over. This one is...
She's giving me cast-on-itis.
Thelophilia. I don't have a good picture that doesn't also show... Sorry. No picture that doesn't show the...
But instead...
But that's the yarn. And that's an LRA.
And that's coming through quite well.
Yeah. It's all these beautiful rainbowy colors. Whoop. Ah! Oh. Yeah. And sorry, just had an idea for another topic for a conversation. Bigger than I thought. All right. This is the artichoke. This is what I have. I have like a few rows on this vest. And I'm pretty sure it's in here.
It's a vest?
Yeah. It's a vesty kind of thing. It's from the Rhinebeck sweater book. Here. Springbrook vest. Sorry, not artichoke. Springbrook vest. So, another one to be evaluated. And then...
Oh my gosh, it's in panda. Panda silk.
Yeah, panda silk. This is... It's called Hearts and Hearts and Shadows on my Ravelry page. Heart and Shadows. And I did another version of this pattern called Light and Shadows. And so this is just these two... I was going to use these two colors. Hold those closer. And knit another one. So that one, can you see those? There you go. A little bit. The red's kind of...
Yeah, the red's kind of blown up the purple.
But it's got all these wonderful purple and pinkish and light reds. And anyway. So I thought it'd be cool. So if you want to kind of see what... that's supposed to be. And if you really think I should knit some of these, I guess you could like vote and say, oh, make sure you do that one.
Yeah, don't rip out that one.
Yeah.
And then this project here.
Oh, that's not going to be, that is not a safe place for that yarn ball.
In your, wool is an essential part of a high fiber diet.
Is.
A project.
No, that's not. It's not supposed to be there. Okay. He did that on purpose.
I did.
Okay, this is...
I mean, I did? I don't know what you're talking
this
about.
This is my Estonian lace scarf.
Jeez.
And you need to hold that up and stretch it out. And it's being... This is silky alpaca lace. And it's the peacock tail and leaf scarf. Don't wave it. Hold it steady so people can focus on it. So, it's really... Don't wave it. There you go. Okay.
But I hate it when people hold it steady. It's so boring.
No, you can't see it if people... You do not. You're just saying that.
Oh, is your this your life cycle scarf?
Yeah, that's the life cycle.
Neato.
So this is my life cycle scarf, and this one's actually pretty close to being done. And this is being done with my hand spun. Mm. So hold this up. So this one is being done with my hand spun, and you need to hold that so people can see the.
We're gonna need to block leaves. This one pretty heavily.
But it looks pretty cool.
Yep, and I'm gonna be needing like, this comes from the
Botanical Knits.
Botanical Knits book.
I have both of them, the first one and the second one.
You're going to be seeing a few more of those because I was looking for a pattern last night.
And he fell in love with.
And she gave me cast on itis.
Everything in both
she
of those
did.
Books.
It's true.
It's like I have to knit all the things.
Is it, well, what I actually said was, I'm seized with a sudden and compelling desire to cast on everything in this book.
Yeah. Word for word what he said. Okay. Peacock tail. Wait. Just a second. We need to get up to date. We need to get up to date.
I got everything.
No, you didn't. You didn't get the peacock tail. And then you didn't get the life cycle scarf. Oh, crap. There's another one.
What?
What the life cycle scarf did not get on the list. Oh, okay. All right. We're good. It did get on the list.
I got it.
All right. And this is the brickless that now
is really only... it's approaching done.
No, it only needs to be bound off. That's it. That's all.
Another one of these? You fiend.
It just needs to be bound off.
Oh, it's wrapped around the zipper
blocked.
Here.
Okay.
There you go.
So, as soon as that's done,
fixed it.
It's done.
I think that one you should frog. It's just not worth finishing.
I know. All of you are screaming at him right now. Like, no, bind it off and give it to me. Send it to me. I'll bind it off. Don't waste all that work. You only need it bound off. Okay, this is... some of these I don't think you guys have ever even seen. So this is my Joker and the Thief.
Ooh, that one. Okay. I was waiting to see what that one looks like.
So,
can you see it?
Yeah, it's got these cool crosses. It's a really neat pattern.
Oh, yeah. It's...
And this is being done with this zobber ball. And so the middle section will change. And it's this cool... And the pink is this other bright pink. So...
It's been so long since you worked on it, she can't remember what it is.
No, it's this is Ba. La Jolla Ba. Ha.
Not quite long enough.
Okay.
This
is my hand spun. And this is a vanishing point hat for my husband.
Yes, it is.
And yes, I know these two browns are almost exactly, but that's the deal. He wanted these two browns and a vanishing point double knit vanishing point hat.
Do you have enough of that other brown?
Yeah, I have more.
Okay.
I have more. That's just what was in my bag. This is...
A pig.
Nope. I love this bag, though.
Look at the cute little piggy.
I totally love this bag.
She won it from Nathan.
From Nathan, from Slot Magician. And this is not... I cannot... I'm so sorry. I cannot pronounce your name. And I don't think you can see that.
Oh, wait. I bet I can pronounce it.
I'll put it in. It's Petra.
I bet I can pronounce it.
No. No, we're not going to worry about it.
I have high pronunciation skills.
A bonbon. This is going to be a bonbon. This is Susan Claudino. Yeah. So this has been started as bonbon. Needs to be finished.
It's Nast design.
Yeah. She's in
or
Germany,
Nast design. It's probably okay. Nast. Knowing that she's German, it's probably Nast. I'm guessing.
This is...
Not that I would know. You've got the buttons on wrong for closing that.
This is a ponytail hat. This is really cool.
Is it a hat for a ponytail, or is it a hat with a ponytail?
It's a hat, so you can put a ponytail at the back.
Gotcha.
Of it.
See, that's what I thought it was.
Okay. I have had this.
Where's the pattern?
I don't know where the pattern is right now. But these are the buttons for it. Needs a button.
Oh, so you put the button
it's
at
cool.
the back.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And this is really a cool thing, but this has been on my... It's either going to get finished or frogged. That's the deal. And it doesn't matter that it's been on my needles for practically as long as I've been knitting.
Yeah, actually. Wow.
That was cast on while I was in the middle of my first shawl, sampler shawl. I had cast onitis even then. She's
always had cast onitis. She just didn't know how to.
This is also one of my patterns. It's a double knitting pattern. Yeah, so that's one of my patterns too.
Yeah, she's always had cast onitis. She just hasn't always been able to cast on.
Headband. Okay. And then...
Sockhead.
Ooh, sockhead.
See, now we're getting to the ones that I know.
Yep. This is the sockhead
and
hat.
And we're gone again.
This is the sockhead hat. And, looky looky. Almost done.
Okay, I think you need to... spend about 2 minutes afterwards.
It'll be done
doing all of your bind-offs and just, like, finishing 5 projects in a row.
It'll take more than 5 minutes. Oh, this is...
I said 2.
This is one that... This is my spin projects. My spin projects that I have to spin for first aren't counted in this cal. This is just things that I have on the needles already.
But why not?
I don't have anything on the needles.
That does not count because that one is a work in progress right over there, okay. And that's not even on the needles yet.
All the yarn and the needles and everything have been decided. That needs to be spun first. The fiber hasn't even been dyed.
Excuses.
Fiber hasn't even been dyed. Okay, this one can't be shown because this is one of my designs. But I can re-show you the yarn from Colorful Eclectic. And that's totally blowing that out, making the pink look much pinkier than it is.
This one. What's this?
Is an experiment.
Experiment.
That was from the workshop where you were...
Oh, okay. So this is experiment number 2?
That's an experiment. That's not a work in progress.
Oh.
Because that was just an experiment.
But if you count it as a work in progress...
Then I can frog it.
That wasn't where I was going with that, but...
All right, just put it over on the side. That's not a project. Okay, this is... Did I put the geology shawl? Yep, geology shawl's on there. This is a geology shawl, which is going to be done with this...
Oh, we did market bag. We did that one.
With this hand spun. Right here. I love this. This is going to be so pretty as a geology shawl. I have 2 skeins of this. Oh, should I show the other one?
It's hand spun. No 2 skeins are alike.
Okay. I have to show it to you that way, otherwise it looks dumb. It looks like plain. Oh, that's just brown. No, it's like all these beautiful colors.
It's like all these fantasticness.
Yeah.
These fantasticness.
All right, so that's the geology shawl. Bonbon. Sockhead hat.
You didn't do bonbon. Oh, I did.
I did bonbon.
No.
I did. I showed bonbon.
No way.
Yes, I did.
Where was it?
Right there.
Oh, in the pig bag.
Pig bag.
Oh, I missed that.
So, bonbon.
Stripey socks. Stripey socks.
Where are they?
Oh, you don't know where your stripey socks are? Shame. Nope, that's mine.
I was sure I brought them in here. Okay, I'm going to have to go get them in a minute. Here.
You forgot your stripy socks. How dare you. Here you go.
All right.
Oh, I know what this one is.
This is my husband's socks. And these count because they were a Christmas gift.
She gave him non-existent socks.
I gave him socks. Alrighty.
No, you gave him non-existent socks. You're going to give him socks.
Oh, and there's a fisherman's rib right there with that Malabrigo.
This one?
Yeah,
this
that one? Malabrigo.
This one? This one.
Mm-hmm. Fisherman's rib cowl. Right here.
That's a fisherman's rib. Doesn't look like it. But that's just a trick of the light. It's actually
That's going to be one of my patterns, too. And the octagon afghan, that doesn't count, so I'm not going to show that right now until I'm working on it again. And the My Design one we did, that was in that bag that I showed, just the yarn. The cuffs. Okay, I am really amazed that this is going so quickly. Okay, these are...
Well, it's because you have a warped perception of time.
Hang on. Okay, show this picture.
You think that 30 seconds is actually really short. Whoa! These are fantastic.
And those are being knit with...
And there's another picture.
This cream colored. Yeah.
It'll look almost exactly like it does in the picture.
This will look like... This is this cream colored yarn, but this is the deal. This is Paco Vicuña. Yeah, it's like, no. This is so soft. I am very excited about those. Okay, put those back over there. That is my...
Sweater. That's what that is.
My pumpkin ale sweater.
Sorry if we bumped the camera.
Pumpkin ale sweater. I'm pulling up a sleeve. This will start getting some serious love and be finished, hopefully.
No, you have to. You have to pull up the whole thing and like...
No.
Put it on tour.
No. Okay.
Have an accident with the needle.
No.
Lose some stitches. All that jazz. No.
My.
This. Oh, or is there something else?
Nope, I don't think so.
What about those over there?
Did I make any progress on this?
What about that yarn?
I haven't done anything new.
Is that yarn one?
That's a weaving project.
Okay. What about?
That's a weaving project. Okay. So I have two squares. I don't think I've done any progress on this, but this is, not included. This doesn't count.
What about that box?
That doesn't have any projects in it.
Okay.
That has a spinning project in it.
Oh, this needs to go with its pattern.
Right here.
Okay.
And it goes in the...
Oh, yeah. Over here. Okay.
The Guernsey socks. I know they exist, but I don't know where they are right now. So those have to be found.
Not at all surprising.
Those have to be found. And then I'm going to go get my stripy socks. Okay, so it turns out I left, but they were actually right down here.
Much time has elapsed.
Not that much.
It was like 10 seconds.
Okay, so these are here. And I don't even think... I think they had the tiniest bit of a whip the last time. Oh yeah, because I had just barely cast them on because it was the January 1st cast on. So I just cast these on January 1st and they were just... Barely done when we recorded.
And I've gotten almost month socks?
All, these are my month socks. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, for the Naughty Knitwit sock thing. So I'm just about ready to... I'm ready to do heels now. So I have to figure out which heel I want to do and then put heels in.
Tell them about your... We've got time. Tell them about your scheme.
My scheme?
For your month socks.
Oh, we talked about it last time.
We did?
So these are kind of like pinkies and reds and stuff. And Valentine-y looking. So I'm doing my... All January, I'm going to be thinking about my Valentine's Day socks that I get to wear during February. And then in March, because we picked a yarn, remember?
Yeah. Instead of knitting socks that coordinated with the month, we're knitting socks so that you can enjoy them during the month.
During the month, yeah.
So...
That's what I'm doing.
At the end of the year, you'll knit some January socks.
Yes. In December, I'll be knitting January socks. That's the idea. So those have gone quite a ways. So I'm not going to do it right now, but I will put progress keepers in all of these before I start working on them again. And then if I frog any of them, I will announce that. And that is... Holy crap, we just went through 43 UFOs. That is the survey of Area 51. That was 43. 42. Oh, because I didn't show those others, because I don't know where it is right now. Okay.
Always losing your knitting project.
You have no idea.
Disgraceful.
You have no idea how many of these were found as I was doing re-shifting my office. That's part of why this was inspired, because it's like, oh yeah, there's this project. Oh yeah, there's this project.
Oh, where is this? There's this project. I didn't know where this had gone.
There was some point that it changed from, oh yeah, to oh no.
It's like, oh crap, there's this project too. So, anyway. So, decisions will be made. And this total, the total that you see, will be down to 10. Or less.
I'm having one of those MasterChef moments.
June 20th. MasterChef moments?
Yeah. One of these chefs will leave the kitchen forever. She's like, only 10 will remain.
So I guess you'll have to do the announcer voice and we'll have to see who got voted out, who got eliminated.
Only 10 will remain.
We'll have to turn it into this big show. Who leaves the needles this episode? Who gets so kicked out this episode?
We are so weird.
We are pretty weird. Okay, so that's my survey. I keep thinking you're banging everything and making...
I'm not. Giving it's earthquakes. Not even touching the camera.
I know, but it's making me nervous. Okay, so...
Or you just moved the table so you could reach the snacks.
Maybe. So I'm good. Mm. I'm all purple.
Look at you, color coordinating.
Color coordinating my cup even with my outfit.
And your brush over there.
Oh, and the brush. The brush is purple too.
You could tell she's having a purple thing.
I am. Okay.
Oh, so I'm good. And your little phone holder.
Oh yeah, he's purple too. Okay. So.
And like three of your bags that I can see right now.
Yep.
You're going to have to finish your sentence to stop me from finding purple things.
You have to give me a chance to finish my sentence. So you have to quit interrupting my talking. All right. So we've got all of...
Oh, and
we've
that back.
The survey. We've done the survey of Area 51. And yeah, that was purple too. He's now just trying to see how... If he can distract me from my sentence. It's now a game that way. All right. It's your turn.
What?
Yep.
Oh! Oh, I get a turn! Okay.
You get a turn.
So, I did some on my cactus. May not look like it, that's because I didn't do much.
But what he's really excited about...
Yes, I am. So, this is a trial run of a pattern that I might be knitting for my lacy thing, for the knit-along. This might be the pattern for the knit-along.
But we have to explain why it might not be. Because he has to knit the pattern, the whole pattern, and nothing but the pattern, right? But there was a funky little thing in how the pattern designer... And you guys have to be able to knit it. You have to be able to get the pattern and look at the pattern and just knit the pattern. And there's a funky little thing that he figured out... But if you just do the pattern the way the pattern, do the pattern and nothing but the pattern.
It ends up like this.
It ends up like that. And I don't know if you can quite tell.
Which I didn't, I stopped because I knew it wasn't right.
There should be ribbing starting
it
right here.
It should look like, one second, I got this. Maybe. I probably have this.
And
it
that
should look like this.
And so you can see the ribbing there.
You can see the ribbing, and then
you need to angle it back toward you.
Oh, okay.
There, like that. There you go.
There. So
there's ribbing there.
Yeah, and then these are like fields of pearl, and anyway, the pattern is Date on the Porch.
And so we'll see.
And it is absolutely beautiful. Look it up. You'll see what I'm talking about.
So we'll see if you can, if the pattern designer adjusts something, because we can't tell you knit this pattern and be able to just knit the pattern if you have to interpret it, and that doesn't really qualify for the dare either. So we're working with the pattern designer and seeing what we can do, and then we will get back to you.
Yep. And if not, I'll still be knitting this. This will still become a project. It won't be in this yarn. I was just picking this.
When we have the decision, though, I will say this. When we have the decision, though, the pattern that he is knitting will go into the thread. So you don't have to wait until.
Yeah, we don't. You don't have to wait until the podcast. You can, and you'll announce it
other places too.
Yeah, I'll put it up on Instagram maybe or something like that.
Yeah. Okay.
And then, but it will go in the thread. We'll put the title,
oh, the pattern, and a link to it. Oh, I think there's like a notification thing on YouTube.
What?
I think maybe there's like an alternate notification thing on YouTube.
I don't know.
I don't know though.
So, those are things I don't know about. So what are we? What else? Do you have anything else to show?
No.
Whoa.
I had so little, they've already forgotten about me. They're still thinking about you.
That was pretty crazy. Alrighty.
Or maybe they can't remember all of the things that you did because you went by so fast, but...
Maybe. We really booked through those. Now we need to do our... Now, I guess we're done with our show and tell, right?
Yes.
We done with show and tell?
We're done with our show survey. Ops.
And let's see. I cannot knit these socks on the podcast. You have to do every other round, you have to purl in the middle. Anyway, to make the little lines for the pencil. Messed it up twice. I've had to go back.
So while she's thinking, I will talk about our featured fiber artist dyer of the month. Yeah, it's a dyer.
Yeah.
This month.
So and wait, we need to pause because we need to go get the prize.
Oh, go get the prize. Okay, I'll run and get the prize while she's tinking, and you won't see any of it.
Our featured maker of the month. Our maker of the month is
WickedEweFiberArts.
WickedEweFiberArts,
and Mandy, I just untied it.
I had placed an order for her. Wait, I had placed an order for her, and she said, she sent this. This came in the order. She said, "Thank you for your order. I am also sending a skein of blue jeans and cowboy boots you can use as a giveaway." So, she kind of gave me the option of keeping it. That is so fantastic.
That she bought 4 other skeins.
Yep. Oops. So, of course, I wanted to use this as a giveaway.
See, it's not just, that is so fantastic. It's a conditional statement. That is so fantastic that she bought 4 other skeins.
I got it in worsted weight and in the same...
And in the fingering weight.
Mm-hmm. And it comes with the stitch marker, too. That cute little snowflake
stitch marker. Yes, this little snowflake stitch marker. I don't know if you saw that.
So, this is the giveaway. This is the giveaway thing that Mandy sent. And thank you so much, Mandy.
Yes, you're fantastic. You.
And Fruit Stripe is hers.
Yes.
And that will be bound off soon. And we have... Do you want to see what I got from Mandy?
I think they do. I think it's in popular demand. Aww. See, your yarn even matches your...
Oh, yeah. Woohoo! It's purple everywhere. And this one is called When Doves Cry.
Oh.
Hold that one up a little closer.
It's a little bit more purple.
Yeah. Really pretty and super soft. Which base is that?
The squishy, the soft base.
BFL. No, this is BFL nylon.
Oh.
Yeah. And I wanted this for a pair of socks because her BFL nylon is awesome. Huh? That's softer. That's the...
This is
Merino. Superwash Merino.
75 Superwash, 25 Nylon, fingering weight.
And this colorway... Wait, say the colorway name.
When is the colorway? Oh, I think I remember the colorway. I just can't quite remember it. Where's the colorway?
It's not written on it.
Did she give us another one?
Oh, no. Do we have to come up with a name? Do we have to come up with a name for that one? I just saw it and loved it and had to have it.
I think we call this one UFO.
UFO. Well, she lives by the... She lives in New Mexico.
See, it's perfect.
By the missile.
It looks very UFO-y, doesn't it? It's got kind of like the green... Kind of
alien.
Alien? No, I say UFO.
Okay, so reach up those.
What? Where?
right there, those worsted weights.
The green?
The green, the green and the blue. That's going to break that chair. Okay, so it's I have two broken. Of these. This is called Rustic Seahawks.
Rustic Sea... Okay.
Mm-hmm. And this is a worsted weight. Superwash. This is beautiful. And I got two worsted... There, I got two of these. And I got two worsted weight of the blue jeans and cowboy boots. So... Woo! More Wicked You. More things to cast on. Thank you, Randy. I'm not looking at his face. I'm only looking at your beautiful yarn, Mandy. Thank you, Mandy. WickedEweFiberArts. Oh, and we have a coupon code
for our viewers. It's Wicked.
Color,
it's
and, color life and Life 20. 20.
All one color word, and life no 20. Caps.
All caps.
Oh, all caps. All one word, all caps.
And then 20 at the end. So beautiful stuff.
Don't hold caps while you press 20, though. That won't work. You'll end up with an at and a end parentheses. At end parentheses. No.
And I have...
Zero.
I have other yarns of hers up there that are just divine, too. Wait. What's that one?
What?
Oh, yeah, I got those, too.
This one?
Reach one of those.
Or,
those
or,
right there.
Or this
no,
one?
No, those.
Are you sure it's not this one?
The blue ones, not the green.
This one?
No, those are the rainbows. We showed those.
Here?
That one.
Okay.
Ooh, stop. Don't lean back. Sit down. And this is hops. So it's got lots more blue in it with just little tiny bits of brown. I love this one too. Love it.
Love it. Are you going to do a musical number for our featured dyer of the month?
Probably not. All right.
It sounded like you were about to break into song.
It sounded like that. Maybe I was about to. Alrighty. So, Mandy, you're wonderful. We love you.
Why didn't you?
Your stuff is great. And please, please, please. We really love Mandy. And her stuff is fantastic.
Go check out her shop.
Yep.
Input your coupon code, 20 Color and Life 20. It's 20% off.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty. Is that it for this episode? Or for this part of this episode?
No, I think that's it for this episode.
It is for this part of this episode. Because this is now...
Oh, I see.
He forgot that we had switched.
No.
So that...
No, I didn't forget that we had switched. I thought you were talking this segment.
Okay, this segment.
Part 1, episode 18 is over. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
That's what we were getting at the whole time.
We're good.
Confusion.
See you later. Thanks for joining us.